Welcome back. We're about to invite Canadian music legend Chris Murphy into the living room. He's a founding member of Sloan. I don't really know what else to say about Sloan except that they are Sloan. He recently finished work as the music director on the Scott Pilgrim graphic novel adaptation directed by Edgar Wright, who made Hot Fuzz and Shaun of the Dead. And he was in Sloan. For anyone who doesn't remember, there was a period of time when a bunch of people thought that Halifax was the next Seattle, and that was because of him. So, ladies and gentlemen, Chris Murphy.
That's it?
Yeah, that's it.
And I sit where you sit.
That's how the show starts. How's it going, man?
Thanks for coming out. That's the house band.
Wow.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, we're really cooking it in here.
Thanks for having me. Yeah, that's cool. So is that going to, you'll take that and you'll sync it with more music, or that was
oh,
it?
Oh, no,
that's it.
That's it.
Oh, great.
Yeah, that's the whole deal.
Yeah.
That's cool.
So far, since you've been to the house, every story that you've told has begun with, you guys probably don't know this.
Yeah, you guys
but
don't know
there's
this
band called Minor Threat.
There's this movie called Do the Right Thing.
Yeah. And, yeah.
When my day.
Yeah, we're not babies.
I appreciate that. But yeah. I guess, like it or not, sort of an elder statesman, spokesman. I'm just.
Do you
old.
Want us to sorry, keep that old. In underneath you?
It's all, I don't care. You know, I'm embracing it. You know, I'm gray. I think that the music that we're making and everything that we're doing is it doesn't make me feel bad to be the age that I am.
Do you say it does make you feel bad? Or
no, it doesn't. Like I don't
it makes
feel,
me feel terrible.
I don't feel undignified. It's like, oh shit, I gotta do this again, yeah. And I gotta wear this big baggy pants and like, and just whatever.
You're not in corn.
That's right. Yeah, those saying. Poor guys.
Yeah,
those guys have to be up there. Aren't they? The guys 40 yet? Are they here?
Yeah, this is really awkward, actually, yeah. Because Korn is in the studio.
Oh, really?
That's cool. Someone else that we had in on our first season of the show was Dave Bedini, and something that we spoke about a little bit was that...
That guy's ancient.
He's more ancient than you, but yeah. He is also in a band that has some really well-loved kind of classic albums.
That's
and
right, yeah.
Being in this band called Sloan, mm-hmm. You guys have some, like, really classic, well-loved records, but you're still an active band making good music, and I wonder, you know...
It is weird because we're constantly sort of competing with ourselves because as we put out new music, you know, demand for it admittedly is lower. Like, we're not part of, like, what's going on or the zeitgeist or whatever. So, like, as we put out music, you know, it's like, hey, we have a new record and there are 30 songs on it. And everybody's like, okay, play Underwhelmed. Like, they're sort of bored of hearing.
Well, that's Korn leaving the studio right now. Bye, Korn.
See you later. Sorry.
We've always had sort of one foot in the industry and one foot out of it, and sort of we've had songs on the radio, we have songs in commercials, like that's how we live. Like we have a song that's been in like the Future Shop ad for like four, like we've been paid four times for that, and that's
awesome.
Basically this huge windfall of money for us that keeps us alive.
Do you get like a free USB key too along with
no,
like,
I go in, I've been in there and I'm just like, I want to say,
you're like,
you know,
hello, don't you know,
can someone help me with these cameras?
You know, for lack of a better comparison, if you say the Rolling Stones, and I don't mean to compare, but like they're putting out however many years that we are into our career, like almost 20. So they were putting out like Tattoo You maybe around that time, mm-hmm. Which, and I don't know if you know this, Tattoo You is actually...
I don't know this Rolling Stones
Tattoo
band.
You is actually pretty good. The record that everybody loves of ours called Twice Removed came out in 1994, and that's getting farther and farther away. And I feel the same way, like my favorite bands, like I like their first three records and then it's just crap, right? You know, really.
Yeah.
But like, and so I find myself feeling for those bands and feeling like, oh, maybe I should check out the season 20 of The Simpsons, even though it's probably not going to be funny. But, you know, I love them so much, and they influence everything. I find myself more tolerant of these things that try to keep going, you know, and try to make consistent work all the time, or Woody Allen or something. Like, I don't know what my point is.
I think the point is that you've compared yourself to the Rolling Stones
Woody
and the
Allen.
Simpsons.
And Woody Allen.
Woody Allen. Yeah. So congrats. I guess you're pretty great. I'm glad we have you on the show.
I was only mentioning things because I don't know the audience. So I don't know how specific they can
These people
get.
Don't know the Simpsons.
Anyway, so Minor Threat and Happy Go Licky and whatever.
Just throw them out there. You're like, do you just Happy Go Licky? That's pretty cool.
G.G. Allen.
Yeah. Great folks.
Good music.
I'm curious, you know, you mentioned you guys, you know, you've made some money from having music in commercials.
Yes.
Blah, blah, blah. One of the other ways that you have been employed recently is doing music supervision or teaching kids how to play rock and roll in the Scott Pilgrim
That's
film,
true.
Correct?
I was in this, there's a movie called Scott Pilgrim versus the World, which are based on the graphic novels of Brian Lee O'Malley. Mm-hmm. And the big marquee name in that is Michael Cera.
And directed by Edgar Wright.
Someone called me, do you want to come meet the guy who did Shaun of the Dead and Hot Fuzz? And I was actually a big fan of those. I sometimes get, you want to come and meet the guy who did... And I'm like, no. But this is like, I love those movies. I love to meet that guy. And so, and one of the things that he asked me is like, you know, do you, when you see a movie and their hands are moving all wrong, does that bother you? And I'm like, yes, that's unacceptable. So basically my job was to just, I was trying to teach the actors who play musicians to be credible. And I had varying degrees of success.
Who was the hardest? Like who couldn't get it?
I think it'll be apparent when you see it.
So you didn't do your job very well is kind of the vibe I'm getting.
I would have liked to have been at casting.
Yeah.
I'd be like, that guy can't play. And he's quite featured. Let's rethink this. Michael Cera?
Yeah.
Michael Cera is excellent. It's super musical. And he knows all about Weezer and he doesn't know anything about Sloan. So that was
so that's fine. At least he was honest.
He's like playing all these Weezer songs. I'm like, whatever.
Did you ask him to play Sloan songs?
No,
like,
I'm not
were you
ask
were
him.
You
no.
like,
you know,
plays
this song,
you know,
Coach Me?
Really,
I've heard it's really
important
good.
To me.
Ha ha.
Yeah, I was going to, but I'm not a complete goof. Like,
dude, that's nice of you.
It's kind of the first like job I've had since the 90s, basically.
It's not a bad job.
Yeah.
There's many worse jobs. What was the last job you had before?
I was a messenger porter at a hospital in Halifax, Victoria General Hospital.
Yeah, working on a movie's way better.
And my marquee thing that I got to do at that job was take bodies to the morgue. It was pretty cool.
It's actually kind of a cool job. Yeah.
So I just carried a beeper and basically just did my own thing. And I actually started playing in this band, and the drummer lived kitty corner from the emergency department. So while I was working, I would go and jam with the band with my beeper on, which is extremely irresponsible.
Sweet.
Do I never need to play to this camera?
don't worry about it.
Am I even on that? Am I in that?
Oh, no, yeah.
No. If you want to make winking faces, do it into
this
that
is
one.
It, yeah.
That's where you make your like
we're
knowing.
We're losing all the like, sarcastic turns.
Cameras so. Without me, and it suggests that you're going to cut what I say. This is bull crap.
Like I said, this
can
is,
I say
this is
that?
A lot.
Yeah. Can I say bull crap?
You can say bullshit. You can say the F word.
You're free. We're going to meet your dicks in this show.
Really?
Yeah.
Actually,
you can show your dick.
Yeah.
As long as it's not exploitative.
Yeah, that was the rule.
That's the stipulation.
Oh, really?
So if you can find a way to do it tastefully,
just like,
that's cool.
I've got a sore, like whatever.
Do you have a macro lens?
Yeah.
No, sorry.
Okay. Well, we're going to come back and chat some more with you. But first, we're going to take a break, and then we're going to head to the basement for a performance from Sandra Lurke.
Is it Lurke or Lurche?
No one knows.
I think it's Lurche. Actually.
Is it?
That sounds more.
Okay.
Sorry, I was trying to do that for comedy.
No,
I don't care.
Yeah, we'll just cut it there.